and I think things over. I can truly say that I've been blessed. I've had a testimony. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. When I look back over my life and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. I have a testimony. I got a testimony. I got a testimony. I got a testimony. I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. When I look back over my life,
back over my life,
and I think things over,
and I think things over,
I can truly say,
I can truly say that I've been blessed.
I have a testimony. When I look back over my life,
when I look back over my life,
and I think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. I have a testimony. I have a testimony.
I got a testimony. I got a testimony. I got a testimony.
I can truly say that I've been blessed. I can truly say that I've been blessed.
I can truly say that I've been blessed.
I can truly, everybody please say, please say,
that I've been blessed.
I can truly say,
can you truly say,
that I've been blessed. I can truly say,
have you made it up in your mind?
I can truly say that I've been blessed.
I've had a testimony.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can truly say that I've been blessed. I have a testimony. I'm standing here before you all. You're standing here amongst others. Amen. You have a testimony. Yes. Hallelujah. Please stand. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. All heads bowed. Everybody, please stand. We go before the Lord in prayer. Lord God, we just say thank you, Lord God. Thank you for the testimonies, Lord. Thank you for giving us an opportunity to be in your presence, Lord God, to receive from you, Lord God, manna from heaven, Lord God, your word. Thank you, Lord God. Let us feast. Let us desire, Lord, to get closer to you, to dedicate our lives to you and live with a purpose, Lord God. That is to do your will, Lord God, to win souls, Lord God. Oh, Lord, hallelujah, we say thank you. Thank you for another opportunity, Lord God, where we're not in the grave, but we're standing before you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for this day, Lord God. Let us cherish it, Lord God, and let us just praise your name today, Lord God. We ask these many blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's go to Ecclesiastes. Amen. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13. Amen. Amen. I'm glad to be back. Amen. Amen. We got a lot of work to do. Amen. Thank you, Lord. When you're there, please say amen.
Amen.
Okay, the word of God reads, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God, keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. Amen?
Amen,
amen. Amen. Right now we're going to have a couple song selections for our very own praise choir. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Since Jesus came into our life, he made a wonderful change. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Since he came into my life,
my
Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
On Him you can depend.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
All you have to do is trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Hallelujah. Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
On Him you can depend.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
All you have to do is trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out. Trust Him and never doubt, for in time He'll bring you out.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
On Him you can depend.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
Trust Him.
Trust in Christ the Lord.
All you have to do is trust Him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
For the rest of my life, I will serve Him.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah
for the rest of my life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If you're saved, you know what that means. For the rest of my life, I'm going to serve him. For the rest of my life, because I didn't serve him until I got saved. Hallelujah. So for the rest of my life, I'm going to serve him forever, forevermore.
Hallelujah. God is good to us. God is good to me. God is good to you. God is good to us. So for the rest of my life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All right, it's offering time. Let's shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I didn't say it. I said shout it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout it again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is an opportunity we get to put something back in the kingdom of God. Amen. We get to put something back in the kingdom of God. Amen. Don't hold your tithe. Don't hold your offering. Amen. Amen. Don't find reason to say I ain't gonna give. Don't find reason to say you're not going to give. We take credit card, we take checks, we take cash, we take coins. Amen. I don't take IOUs. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Isn't God wonderful? Amen. He's good. He's wonderful. He's just God. Amen. I'm glad I'm saved. Glad I'm saved. I wouldn't have it no other way. You got people saying the Bible been handed down by the old folks. We got folk that just don't believe in the Bible. We got people that just say man wrote it. If man told me to stop cussing, thank you, man. If man told me to stop stealing, thank you, man. Amen. Thank you. Because I'm glad I don't cuss no more.
Amen.
Listen, I'm glad I don't steal no more. I'm glad I ain't in the back room gambling, waiting for somebody to bust a cap in me no more, shooting, rolling loaded dice. Amen. I'm glad somebody told me don't do that no more. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. I'm glad somebody told me to go to church and stomp your feet and shout hallelujah. Amen. So thank you, man, for writing the Bible. Amen. I'm glad man told me to leave other folks' wives alone. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad man told me to stop mistreating folks. I feel good. I don't hate nobody no more. But man wrote it. Hey, man, keep on writing. Hey, man, keep on writing. That's some good stuff you writing. I appreciate it. Hey, I'm glad man told me to stop drinking and driving. Amen. I think I've lived a little bit longer since I stopped doing that. Amen. Folk want to put the Bible on everybody except the one that wrote it, which is God himself. Amen. And then folk trip me out. They got the nerve to say, man wrote that. Man wrote that part. Everything, Beverly, everything you don't like, man wrote that part. Man wrote that part. All that part you like, amen, about giving it come back to you, God wrote that because you like that. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, child, hallelujah. Let us stand. Let us stand and follow the direction of our ushers. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. They say man wrote give your tithe. So man told y'all to put something in the church so you can have a church to come to. Thank you, man. Because if I didn't put money in it, we might not have a church to come to, huh? Man. Man wrote that part, give the preacher the money. I'm glad. We got to pay him. He might not come to work. If he don't come to work, how are he going to preach to us?
Right.
Amen. Amen. Just show you all that stuff that folk be saying. Just twist it.
Come on.
All right, I'm going to preach in a minute. But right now, I'm going to put you in the hands of our praise choir and our ushers. Follow the directions of the ushers. Amen.
Amen.
We come to glorify his name. We come to glorify his name. We come to glorify the name of the Lord. Glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to glorify
his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to glorify
the name of the Lord.
We come to
glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify the name of the Lord.
We come to
glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify the name of the Lord.
Come on, let's
glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify the name of the Lord. Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify the name of the Lord.
We come to
glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Come on and
glorify the name of the Lord. Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
His name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify the name of the Lord.
We come to
glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
Glorify his name.
We come to
glorify the name of the Lord.
We come to
glorify his name.
My hands were made to worship you. My heart, my being, it beats for you. Oh, I am so true. Surrender to you
my life.
I give
my love.
I give
my all.
My hands were made to worship you.
Surrender to you my life.
I give
my love.
I give
my all.
Your touch, your kiss, your grace to me is deep.
Call out your name, my life.
gift,
my love,
my gift,
my all.
Your touch, your kiss, your grace to me is deeper than my soul can see. My purpose it changed when I call out your name.
My life
I give,
my love
I give,
my all,
my all. Has been erased with just one touch from you. My clouds, my rain, my pain has changed. Your blood has made me new.
Oh, that's so true. I surrender.
I give
my love,
I give
my all,
my all,
my all,
my
past.
My past has been erased with just one touch from you. My clouds, my rain, my pain has changed. Your blood has made new.
Oh, that's so true.
I surrender to you.
My life
I give,
my love
I give,
my all.
And when this world I give
my love,
I give
my all,
my all,
my all,
my past. My past has been erased with just one touch from you. My clouds, my rain, my pain has changed. Your blood has made
my love.
Come on, shout hallelujah. 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 I love that song. Love that song. Hallelujah. I like them songs that make me think and look back. Reminds me what God has done and what I need to do. I got to give him everything I got. Everything. My life, my love. My all. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I'm glad God called me to the ministry, the pastor and the preacher. Amen. Because I love it. I love it. And I know I didn't do anything to be worthy of it. Amen. While I was getting high, he was ordaining me to be a preacher. Yes. Ain't that something? Hallelujah. That's why I can't go back. Can't go back. That's it. Amazing grace. Amazing grace. That's the way the man felt when he wrote the word to that song, a slave trader. He was bringing slaves to the United States, and somehow God got a hold of his heart, and he wrote the song, Amazing Grace. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He was selling humans for money, abusing them and beating them, but when God saved them, he said, Amazing Grace. Hallelujah. Sometimes we got to know how these songs came about. Man said, Amazing Grace. Listen, hallelujah. I like what Paul said. Paul said, I was a chief sinner. Chief sinner. Paul said, nobody could beat him sinning. That's the way I look at me. Nobody could beat me sinning. But for some reason, God decided. God decided. Man didn't decide. John didn't decide. God decided. I can use John. Use me? Who, me? Jesus. No, you can't use me. I can use a fella like John. I can get him to preach for me, to live for me, to talk for me, to stand for me, to believe in me, convince others. God said, I can use John. Me? The chief of all sinners? Nah, Lord. I ain't fit. Not fit. Not fit. Not fit. Never been fit. Somehow, God saw something. Or should I say God sees something? Oh, hallelujah. John don't see yet. I don't see nothing yet for me to be used for the kingdom of God. I don't see nothing about me yet. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, because everything I do, he gives me the strength, he gives me the wisdom, he gives me the knowledge, he gives me the thought, he gives me the memory, he gives me the ability, he gives me the hand, he gave me the feet, he gave me the vocal cords, he gave me the eyes, he gave me the ears, he gave me the head, gave me the heart. So I don't see nothing in me yet. For God, the God, a creator of all the earth, said, I can use John. Hallelujah. That's why the man said, what is man that thou art mindful of him? God is good, y'all. I think sometimes we don't know that or believe that, and we think we got some kind of special ability. I ain't got nothing. Maybe y'all got a special ability, but I don't have nothing. I don't have nothing. I don't have nothing. I don't have nothing but God. God said, I'm going to use that boy there. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So my life, my love, my all, he can have all of it. He can have all of it. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Title of the message today is The Instrument of God. Do you want to be an instrument of God? Not for God, of God. That means God is his instrument. He can do whatever he want to do with it. Amen. It's his instrument. Amen. Hallelujah. It's his instrument. You know, we buy our clothes, we buy our car, and we say, mine. This is mine. It's mine. I can do what I want to do. Amen. I can't come in none of y'all house and tell y'all how to arrange y'all furniture. That's your house. That's your furniture. Oh, hallelujah. God said, when y'all going to become my instrument? When y'all gonna become my instrument? God wants us to be his instrument. So we're gonna talk about being the instrument of God. Come on, Romans chapter 6. The instrument of God. But we sit around with our attitudes. We sit around and think we know something and think we good. Listen, hallelujah. When are you going to just say, I'm the instrument of God? I don't do nothing. I don't think nothing. Hallelujah. Whatever God say, hallelujah. Whatever God does, hallelujah. Amen. I want to be an instrument of God. Amen. Hallelujah. The instrument of God. The instrument. The time for God, for us to let God do whatever he wants to do with us. Amen? Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Folks want to say you got a mind, but he told you don't use it. He said, take no thought. Trust in the Lord. Lean not to your own understanding. Yeah, I gave you one. Amen. That car got a mind of his own. Take your hand off the steering wheel and see what it does. Amen. The mind of that car or your truck or any vehicle you got, the mind is to destroy itself. Take your hand off it and watch what it does. Gonna run into something, ain't it? Oh, hallelujah. Y'all gonna get this. God take his hands off of us, what we gonna do? We're gonna run into something. When he barely had his hand on us, all we did was run into something, didn't we? Amen. That's called the life we live before we got saved. If God was to take his hand off us, y'all. What the Bible say, if God was to mark iniquity. Ooh, hallelujah. So why don't we be the instrument of God? Let him grab us and let him guide us. Let him direct us. Let him take us where he wants us to go. Because as soon as you stop listening to the word of God, man, you're in a world of trouble. Amen. When you debate the word of God, hallelujah. Thank God. Listen, I think you know how to live and direct God. Listen, how can you think like God when God gives you your thoughts? You can't think like him. The thoughts you get, he gives them to you. But you can think like him, huh? Oh, hallelujah. Romans chapter 6. You got it? Hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Verse 13. Read, what does it say? Neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your members as instruments. Read it again. Come on, verse 13. We're talking about the instrument of God. Come on, read. What does it say? Neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto. Stop sinning. Stop letting your mind, your hand take you into an area you know that is wrong. Come on. What does it say? But yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead. Are we alive from the dead? We say we've been born again. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. So why we keep going back to that dead mentality? Come on, read. He said what? And your members as what? Righteousness unto God. Time to think like Jesus. Time to talk like Jesus. Time to walk like Jesus. Time to believe like Jesus. Time to be little Jesuses. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Listen, it's time for us to live like Jesus. Listen, talking about the instrument of God. Don't you want to be an instrument? Let God use you. Oh, hallelujah. That's what we've been talking about with these gifts and y'all getting in the different auxiliary. You said, I want to be used of God. I want God to tell me what to do. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, that's a wonderful thing. Let's go to Acts chapter 2. It's time for us to become instruments of God. Amen. We read about being addicted to helping folk. We got to get addicted to helping folks. All I want to do is help folks. All I want to do is encourage somebody. All I want to do is get somebody to church and get them saved. That's all I want to do. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 2. Thank you, Lord. Chapter 2. I want to go to verse 42. We know what this is all about. They done got the Holy Ghost. They speaking in tongues. Peter preached a sermon. They got baptized in the name of Jesus, not the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. They got baptized in Jesus' name. They believed the word, and then they said, we're going to live this thing, man. Hallelujah. Come on, verse 42 said what? And they continued steadfastly in the apostle doctrine and in fellowship. Come on, read that again. And they continued steadfastly in the apostle doctrine and fellowship and the breaking of bread and the prayer. In other words, they started a whole new family. That we call it apostolic. We call it apostolicity. Hallelujah. Y'all came to church of apostolicity and y'all said, I want to start a whole new family. You got to continue. Amen. That's what we do over here. We just come out fasting. We praying around the clock. Listen, this is a whole new. Let's continue steadfast. Amen. Come on. Verse 43 says what? And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done. Listen, why can't we get to the point where people be afraid to mistreat us? People be afraid to pass by the front of this church. People be afraid to come in here because they know if I go in there, something going to change in my life. Hallelujah. But let them come on in. They need to change. What do we got to do? We got to become the instruments of God. If we let God do and tell us what to do, listen, it's amazing what we can't do. Come on, verse 44 say what? He said, and all that believe were together and had all things. It's time for us to think a lot. We got too many ideas in here. It's time for us to think a lot. The number one rule here, I'm saved first. The number one rule when I'm at home, I'm saved first. The number one rule when I leave here, I'm saved first. The number one rule on my job, I'm saved first. The number one rule when I'm driving a car, I'm saved first. Listen, let's all get the same mind. I'm not going to respond to this flesh. I'm not going to yield my members to the flesh no more. I'm going to yield my member to righteousness. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, verse 45. And they sold their possessions and good and parted them to all men and every man. Listen, it's time for y'all to put your money and your time in the church. I'm not asking you to sell your good, but dedicate your life. Get addicted. The man say that the family got addicted. Amen. When I was addicted to dope, I went out and got a second job just to support my addiction. Say it again. I had a second job just to support my addiction. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. How many of y'all got a second job just to make this church grow? Just to make the house of God get better? Just to make your life get better? What am I saying? When you're addicted to something, some of y'all sold your body for some dope. Oh, hallelujah. Beverly was willing to sleep on the street just so you can get high. God, we're talking about addiction. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, when we going to get to the point that our instruments are the instruments of God? God do whatever. Because the devil, when he had these instruments. Oh, hallelujah. That boy did whatever he wanted to do. Oh, thank you, Jesus. He used me to drive while I was drunk. Talking about the devil controlling me. Hallelujah. But we don't want God to use us for nothing while we sober. Every time we get right in our mind, we get a raise, we want a new car. We get a raise, we want a new coat. Why can't you get a raise and say, I'm increasing my offering. Hallelujah. Every time, oh, thank you, Jesus. Every time God bless you, listen, you want to take what he gave you to make you and the devil look better. Oh, hallelujah. When we going to get something from God and I'm going to use it just to make me and Jesus look better. Oh, hallelujah. Hey, what are we talking about? Instruments of God. I want God to tell me what to do. I want God to direct me. I want God to control me. Hallelujah. Come on, read that again. He said what? And they sold their possession and good and parted them to all men, and every man had need. Listen, I'm not asking you to sell nothing for me. I'm asking you to take what you got and give it to God and watch God keep it coming. Oh, hallelujah. Watch God keep it coming in. But y'all don't want to do that because y'all got instruments of unrighteousness. Listen, I want to be an instrument. I want to be an instrument of God. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Verse 46 said what? And they continued daily one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart. Listen, the only way we're going to get to this point, listen, y'all got to come to the prayer meeting. Listen, y'all don't want to come to prayer. Y'all don't want to get here early. Y'all don't want to do nothing extra if it ain't Wednesday or Sunday. And you're slow about those 2 days. Listen, you got to come to prayer. You got to fast. When the pastor call a fast, you need to fast. Hallelujah. When the pastor asks for a special offer, you need to give it. When the pastor said come to prayer, you need to be here. Listen, when are we going to get it? I'm an instrument of righteousness. I'm an instrument of God. So I don't get to do what I want to do no more. That's why I teach you minister. When you talk about you a minister and you want lights in your life, go on the shelf. Don't pick it up no more. You just died because you just became an, oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, when I bought that truck did not belong to the dealer no more. The dealer can't touch my truck unless I take it back to them. They can give me a warranty, but I can do whatever I want to do. That's my truck. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, we belong to Jesus Christ. So why would keep running to the devil for repair? Why you keep running to the devil? Oh, thank you, Lord. Y'all keep running to Satan for repair. I'm going to the one that made me. I'm going to the one that tell me how to deal with anger. I'm going to talk to the one that tells me how to deal with love. I ain't going back to the one that teach me how to get better at lusting. I'm going to the one. I'm going back to the maker. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Read that again. They continue steadfast. Listen, we got to keep coming to prayer. We got to keep coming to church. We got to get here and get everything. We can't miss Sunday school. Sunday school is just the beginning of my Sunday morning service. But y'all don't come to Sunday school. Y'all don't know that. That's why y'all far behind when I'm preaching. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 47 said what? And listen, when you come to God and you get singleness of heart, look what happened. Verse 47 says what? Praising God and having favor. And the Lord does what? He does what? Listen, we don't add to the church. Jesus add to the church. But if you don't, oh, hallelujah. If you don't let him use you, you ain't going to bring nobody to church. So I'm telling y'all why y'all can't get nobody to come to church. That's why you can't get folks here, Beverly. You ain't no instrument. Amen. You let him use you when you feel like it. That don't work. How would you like for your car to operate when it feel like it? You wouldn't care much for that, would you? I need to go to work in the car. So I don't feel like going. Amen. Listen, y'all may say that's dumb. That's a car. That car can't move without me. You got it. You're dumb when it comes to Jesus. You can't move without Jesus. If Jesus don't press your button, you can't think. If Jesus don't press your button, you can't see. If Jesus don't press your button, but y'all seem to think y'all can press your own button. That's why you keep running into something. That's why you keep running into stuff. Listen, that's why you're always hanging. You busted up and worried and scared about something. Oh, but you let Jesus, oh, holler. What am I? If Jesus press your button, you ain't running into nothing. And if you do, you're going to knock it over. Why? Because you got, oh, hallelujah. So supporter's car can't handle what my truck can handle. She got them little high performance tires on there about this thick. Amen. Car sitting this low to the ground. Hit that little bump, everything drags. But let that Yukon hit it. Ooh, hallelujah. All you hear is the boom, boom. Boom, boom. Hers hit it. What's wrong with my car? You trying to make it do something it can't do, honey. Hallelujah. Then I get in her car. She said, you're driving my car like you drive your truck. That's right. So let me get out from behind the wheel. Because I don't know how to drive no sedity stuff. I know how to drive man-made, rough, tough stuff. What am I saying? It's time for y'all to become some saints with some backbone. Y'all stop being weakly. Listen, it's time for y'all to do what God tells you to do so you can bring folks into church. Y'all worried about folks hurting your feelings. Listen, you're too delicate. I don't want no delicate car. I ain't got time to drive over the road like this, dodging every bump. Let me run over some of them. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, I ain't got time to preach to make y'all happy. Let me sock you in the face and let you know you got problems so you can get it right. Listen, hallelujah. What are you saying? Listen, I'm an instrument of God. I ain't here to make things good for you. I'm here to make things right for you. I'm not here to make things better. I'm here to make things right. Listen, what's better and what's good ain't right. What you talking about? What you talking about? We talking about becoming an instrument of God. People wanna say, don't preach about that. Do you read it in the Bible? Yeah, well then why can't I preach about it? If God had the nerve, the gall to put it in there, create it, why can't I say something? Amen. Don't that make sense? If God wrote it, why can't I talk about it? Hallelujah. What are we talking about? Let God add to the church. Listen, folk that are unsaved, listen, they just as mean and low down as we were. Some of us still are. Amen? Come on.
Come on. I'm gonna preach decent today, if there's such a word. Come on. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I love being saved. Listen, I know this is right. And I know you can't, you ain't gonna get saints preaching smooth stuff. You only gonna get Christian. I ain't no Christian, I'm a saint. Amen. I need perfection. I don't need soothing over. I don't need correcting at this level. Hit me square in the mouth and tell me you can't gamble no more. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Come on. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. You got it? What are we talking about, y'all? Instruments of God. Stop yielding yourself over to sin so easy. Stop giving into things that you know ain't right. Listen, that's you yielding. You yielding. Hallelujah. Listen, we all know sometimes if you don't yield, there's an accident, ain't it? Some of y'all don't like yielding. That's why y'all cars always bumped up and busted up. Because y'all won't yield. Sometimes let that legend, let that fool go. Let them go. Amen. They in a hurry, let them go. Hit your brakes. Let them go. Let them get in front of you. Amen. Sometimes, oh, here's my right of way, and both y'all in an accident, but you got your right of way, didn't you? Hallelujah. Listen, it's time for us to stop saying what's right by me and yield to your brother. Yield to your sister. Yield to the sinner. Agree with your adversary quickly. In other words, they hate you, but give them the right of way. Oh, love your enemy. You know they don't like you. They're your enemy. Love them anyway. Yield. What am I saying? It's time for us to yield unto righteousness and stop thinking everything belonged to us. Hallelujah. Jesus yield to all of our no good self. Hallelujah. But look what he's saying at the talking about instruments of right. It's time for you to yield to your brother. Yield to your sister. Yield to the sinner. Let them do what they want to do. He said, don't do it. He said, give place unto wrath. He said, fight. Don't fight it. Give it place. Let them have it. Somebody want to talk about you? Let them do it. Yield. Let them do it. Hallelujah. He said, you in good company. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. It ain't yours. But we keep wanting to yield. Ain't nobody going to treat me like this. God didn't make no fool. Well, chapter 6. We'll preach about that another day. Come on. Come on. Chapter 6, you got it? Oh, I feel good. Lord, why you got me preaching so hard this fast? Come on, verse 1. What did you say? We then, as working together with him, we'll be working together with. Listen, we ain't working about ourselves. Jesus is right here with us. He's right here helping us. He said, I give y'all the idea to do what you do. He said, I ain't gonna never leave you nor forsake you. You think Jesus ain't with me when I'm telling y'all to do what he said do? Jesus is with you as long as you tell folk to do what Jesus said. Not, oh, hallelujah. Come on. He said from the top, verse 1, read. We then, as working together with you, beseech you also that you receive not the grace of God. Listen, what God has done for us, don't you throw it away. Don't treat it like it ain't nothing. Listen, that's why I got up and almost got to crying, because God thought about me when I was no good and still no good. God entrusted me, a no good low down scoundrel, with his word to get up here and say the truth. Listen, cause God said, John, I'm gonna be the one talking. It's just gonna be your vocal cord they gonna hear, but I'm the preacher. You are just a vessel. What are you talking about? He's working together with us. Y'all, he ain't leaving us, but you gotta believe that. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Come on. What are we talking about? The instrument of God. Listen, listen, people get in my truck and they say, man, I can't hear this truck running because I own it. I treat it right. I mean, I ain't ready to get rid of it yet. I mean, every time I see a good deal on a vehicle, I said, oh, but my truck run good. Why it run good? Because I took care of it. What am I saying? Listen, the reason we are good saints, y'all, because God take care of us. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What did I tell y'all last week? Ain't nobody in this congregation sickly. Y'all think y'all doing good because y'all? All of us in here obese. Y'all don't have to like it. Remember, I don't preach to make friends. I'm preaching to make you be healthy. I'm preaching to make you have some wisdom. Listen, we all obese. I was looking at you standing up there. You used to didn't have no belly. Your belly is bigger than mine now. I watched and I said, man, Lord, because see, I'm losing weight. I said, his belly just hanging over his belt buckle like mine now. But I remember when you didn't have no belly. Oh, all of us in here is obese. And you think you healthy because of what? Listen, only because God looked. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God said, I'm not going to let you be in vain. Just do what I tell you to do. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I make you obese and still let you be in good health. Don't put one gauge work on my instrument panel. That's the one that revs the engine, the RPM. Folks get in my car, they say, you out of gas? I go, what made you say that? Because your hands say E. And you think I'm dumb enough to ride around on E. You really think I'm that dumb? It's in my face. You got to look over there and see it. And oh, hallelujah. God, you good. I like this. God say, y'all think John crazy. Y'all think John is mean because the way he preached. Wait a minute. I thought he belonged to me. So what makes you think I don't know how this boy preached? He belongs, that's my instrument. Listen, that's my car. I know when it's low on gas. I know this is my car. Listen, how fast you going? I know that too. How you know that? Because I got another thing I put in there, and I learned that when I'm at a certain speed, my wife was driving, I was half asleep. I said, baby, you're over 80. How you know? I know how this baby run. I know when it's really smooth, you always, listen, you done passed 80, because it vibrates a little bit, but when it hit that 80, it's my car. I know my car. When I get in her car, I can't tell what I'm doing. I got to constantly drive and look at the, trying to see what my speed is. I get in my speed. Police pulled me over one time. He said, you know you were going 80. I said, that sounds about right. That's what I drive. I don't have to see what I'm going. I know what I'm driving. That's what I drive. I drive 80 when I'm on the free. Oh, hallelujah. What are you saying? God said, I know my people. My sheep, I know them, and I call them by name. Oh, hallelujah. Do God know you by name? Are you his instrument? Come on. Come on. Come on, hallelujah. Verse 2 said what? That ain't the script I come over here for. Read, what does it say? For he said, in a time accepted, in the day of salvation, has I succored thee. Behold, now is the acceptable time. Behold, now is the day. Succored meaning the only reason you here is because I drawed you here. Succored meaning I drew you. See, folk don't know what that word means. They just read and don't have no idea. Succored meaning, so God said, wait a minute. Tell me something. For he said, I have heard thee. God said, I heard you. I heard you in the time of what? I heard you when I got ready to hear you. When I wanted to pay attention to you whining and crying about all your illnesses and worries. God said, I decided when I want to listen to you. Listen, hallelujah. I could fix that panel on that truck if I want to. Because they told me the only problem with that is out of sequence. The magnets or something is gone bad. So everything is off. Hallelujah. So I know what the problem is. It ain't broke. Hey, amen. Not in my mind because I know how to get it fixed. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, God say, I heard you. When you was whining and crying, I know wasn't nothing going to happen to you because I got your back. But you didn't know that. Listen, I hear you crying. I hear you calling on me. But I hear you in a time accepted. Oh, hallelujah. I started getting high when I was 14 years old. But God didn't save me until I was a stone fool. He didn't pull me out the world until I was a stone alcoholic, 28 years old. God knew I was getting high when I smoked my first joint, but he didn't help me until the time accepted. He said, John, when you come, I'm the one that's going to draw you. When you get here, listen, if I can wait all those years to save you, don't you think I know what I'm doing? Talking about an instrument. Oh, hallelujah. Talking about an instrument. Come on. He said, well, I have heard thee in the time accepted. In the day of salvation have I served. Listen, let me tell you something. You ain't saved today. God said the only reason you're here today because he wants you saved. He wants you to get baptized. He wants you to get the Holy Ghost because he said he secured you. I drew you. Listen, y'all didn't come to see me today just because you heard about. You've been heard about me. But today is the day of salvation for you. God said, this day have I secured you. This day have I drew you. This day I want you to change. This day. But we always want to wait. I'll do it another day. Another day. And it's amazing. All them people say, I'm going to do it another day, never come back. You know why? Because they're a car with no driver. See, God drove us. God driving us today because we're his instrument. So he drives us to the church of apostolicity and said, now get saved. You hear the right message. You hear the message that you've been wanting to hear. But you don't want to hear it because you think you got time to do it another day. He said, harden not your heart as they did in the provocation. He said, the day you hear the voice of the Lord. Oh, holly, I like that. Thank you, Jesus. And that still ain't the verse I came for. Come on. Verse 3 say what? Giving no offense in anything. Don't blame the ministry because it's hard. And today is your day to get saved or get better. And you don't want to do it, but you don't like the way this man up here presenting it to you. Don't blame the ministry for that. Listen, hallelujah. You're a liar, ain't you? I'm just reminding you what you are that you don't want to accept. Listen, you're crooked, ain't you? Yeah, listen, ain't you got a problem with loving folk? So don't blame the ministry because that's the way you are. Be glad. That's why he say the grace is in vain. The grace is the preaching of the gospel. So the preaching remind you what you are and you blame the preacher. Well, I don't think it means what you think it means. Angry, what you think angry means. Low down, listen, what do you think that means? But you'll be the first one to say, oh, they low down. So when somebody call you low down, what are we talking about? Don't yield your instruments under unrighteousness. Listen, you might as well bow. The word of God ain't going to change. Oh, hallelujah. Stop blaming the ministry. Stop blaming church of apostolicity. It's time for you to blame yourself. Hallelujah. You can talk about adultery all day long and I'll never get mad because I don't commit adultery. Ooh, hallelujah. I don't have to worry about that one. I ain't telling you what I worry about. Don't talk about it here. No, you don't need to hear. Worry about yours. Amen. I'm telling you one I don't worry about. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you. And then when I do hear myself talk about me, I don't get mad. Like, man, Lord, you're right. I ain't blaming the ministry. I'm thanking the ministry. Come on. Come on. Verse 4, he said, what? But in all things. Oh, I love this. Come on, y'all, read with me. What does he say? But in all things, approving ourselves as the minister, approving ourselves as the minister, approving ourselves as the instruments of God. Listen, hallelujah. Some of y'all are good. Some of y'all are so what, but you just as dull. You so dull, you can't beat a person into the church. You so dull as a sword, you can't even kill them. Boy, I like being sharp. I like cutting folks. You know how you get cut real? You ever been cut real good with a sharp knife? Boy, it cuts you so fast you don't even know you cut. Before you could say, out blood shooting. So I ain't never been cut so fast. You get cut so fast, man, you like, before you could say, ouch, you run and get in a band-aid. That's why I like about my preaching. That's why I like about the way God preached me. I cut you so fast that you get mad later. Amen. You think about, oh, he said something. Yeah, that's the kind of cutting I like. Because when you done thought, listen, because you know good where it fits you. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. In all things, approving ourselves as the ministers of God, in much patience, in affliction, in necessity, in distress, in strife, in prison. Come on, read. In torment, in labor, in watching, in fasting, by pureness, by knowledge, by long-suffering, by kindness, by the Holy Ghost, by love of friend, by the word of truth, by the power of God, by the armor of righteousness on the right hand and on the left, by honor and dishonor, by evil report and good report, as deceivers, but yet true. As unknown, yet well known. As dying, behold, we live. As chastened and not killed. And sorrowful, yet always rejoicing. As poor, yet making many rich. And having nothing, and yet I own everything. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Poor, poor. I like to classify myself as poor. But look how many of y'all I done made rich. Look how many of y'all out of made rich. You say, Pastor, you didn't do nothing. Don't you know if you hadn't been under this ministry, you wouldn't be where you are today. You can say what you want. You would not be where you are today. You are where you are because of the preaching that got you right, and God was able to use you. So it's time for you to continue to let him use you now to be an instrument to get somebody else in. Amen. If God used me to get you, when you going to let him use you so you can get somebody? Because y'all blunt objects. You're blunt. You're supposed to be a sword. And y'all are, listen, y'all worse than a thump. All a tree thump does is. Don't do nothing, does it? Some of y'all ain't number thumps. Time for y'all to stop being thumps. Time for y'all to do something. Tired of hearing that I'm afraid to do something. Listen, you wasn't afraid to talk to that little old girl that you was interested in that you didn't know. You wasn't afraid, listen, you wasn't afraid to approach that boy you thought was handsome. When you wanted to jump in the bed with somebody, you wasn't afraid, were you? You wasn't afraid to try some marijuana that probably would kill you. Hallelujah. You wasn't afraid to try no whiskey. And how stupid we were. We wasn't afraid to drive drunk. We wasn't afraid to try no Sherman. You wasn't afraid to sleep with a girl that you didn't know. You could have got AIDS. You could have got VD. We called the claps. Come on. Don't say I can't talk about it. It's in the Bible. Listen, y'all wasn't afraid to do none of that, but you were afraid to tell somebody about Jesus. Talking about being an instrument of God. I don't know what to say. You didn't. Listen, what did you say when you saw that girl? I'm gonna find a way. I know her. Hey, baby. You figured it out, didn't you? Satan put it in your head. Why don't you just go there and say, hey, baby? Why don't you walk over there cool? Why don't you walk over there? Listen, you can tell what she like. She like pretty boys. So why don't you dress up tomorrow when you go to school, look like a pretty boy and watch, because you see her saying, oh, he handsome. Listen, you done picked up all the vibes of what she like. Y'all laughing because you know it's true. Why can't you pick up the vibes of a sinner and see where they are? Why can't you pick up the vibes of a sinner and say that they're sad? Why can't you pick up the vibes of a person that's angry? Say, hey, man, what's wrong with you? How can you have a bad? Why don't you pick up, but you don't want to be an instrument of righteousness, but you love being an instrument of the devil. But you don't want to be an instrument of God. All of a sudden, you can't figure nothing out no more. Oh, hallelujah. What are we talking about? Listen, he said, listen, as unknown, yet well known. As dying, and behold, we live. As chastened is not killed. As sorrowful, yet always rejoicing. As poor, see, folks, I done heard folks say, y'all Christian folk. First of all, you just excluded me because I am not a Christian. I'm a saint. Let's get that straight, first of all. But for the sake of discussion, he said, y'all Christian folk, y'all sad. Who told you that? I get an attitude when y'all walk in here sad, don't I? Because you ain't nothing. What you sad about? We own everything. We own what they say, as having nothing and yet. I'm going to show you in a second. I got everything. I got the power of God in my hand. I just don't know how to use it because I don't know how to yield to being an instrument of righteousness. But I know how to yield to being an instrument of unrighteousness. We always make that statement. Now that I'm saved, now that I've been married, I don't know how to date again. I ain't telling that lie no more. I'm just not looking to date. Put me in the position. I remember I used that statement that brother used over at Vaughn when he saw this girl passing by. He was sitting there all high, leaning. He looked at the girl. He said, I like that earth tone. I used that. I start off, hey, I get back in the world. Okay, Lord, I remember. Oh, I like that earth tone, baby. What am I saying? Stop saying what you can't do. You can do it. All you got to do is pull up that old evil memory and watch how good you can do it. When we going to pull up some righteous thoughts? When we going to, oh, hallelujah. The man just gave you a bunch of, pull up some of this righteous stuff and become an instrument of righteousness. Stop, oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Time, we doing good. I want somebody to get saved today. Come on. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Let's go there. You got it? Same book. Oh, hallelujah. Chapter 10. God is good. It's time to become an instrument of God. Listen, we spend too much time doing evil stuff, y'all. It's time to stop that. It's time to get folks in the church. It's time for us to reach out and get souls in. It's time for us to bow down and say, Lord, what you need me to say? Tell me how to say. Y'all, some of y'all in college, y'all can't get nobody. Y'all on your job, you can't get nobody. All y'all will walk around. Who gave you your job? I'm asking you, who gave you your job? I want to answer. Who gave you a job? Your job, not a job, your job. Who gave it to you? Who put you in the school where you are? What you think he put you over there for? So how come you ain't have nobody here? Y'all want to talk about, Lord bless me with a job. How many folks you done got here? How many folks you done got here? You giving glory for the job, giving God the glory for the job. How many of you done got saved? How many of you done brought to church? How many? How many? So God gave you the job to keep some money in your pocket. He could have made you a dish dick and put money in your pocket. He could have put you in a whole lot of positions to put money in your pocket. He gave you that job to get somebody to church. He gave you that job to win some souls. Instrument of unrighteousness. Did you ever, anybody in here, did you ever have a job when you was in the world drinking that you couldn't get nobody to go to happy hour with you? Did you ever have a job that you couldn't get nobody to go to the club with you? I got one that's going to shake you. How many of us worked with folk could get them to go to a house party in an area they didn't normally go in, but they went with you because they trusted you? What am I talking about? Y'all yielded to the devil. When you going to yield to Jesus like that? Why you can't convince folk to come hear this type of preaching? Because they trust you. I convinced women to go to bed with me on a one night stand. Didn't know nothing about me. And they convinced me. I said, baby, I'm clean. She said, baby, I'm clean. We in the bed. Come on, let's deal with reality. What are we talking about? When we was unrighteousness, when we were living in unrighteousness, we yielded and we did what the flesh told us to do. Now we hollering about, I'm saved. I got the Holy Ghost. And you ain't got nobody at church and got them saved yet. Get them here one time. And then when they tell you, well, your pastor preached too hard. And listen, y'all too afraid to stand in their faith. Well, say, mama. So mama say, well, you know, he talking about whore. Mama, are you a whore? Girl, don't talk to me. Well, no, mama, he called you a whore. Let me ask you, do you think you a whore? Because when I took somebody to a club and they holler about, well, you know, the girls wasn't that pretty. And I said, well, let me ask you, did you have a good time? Well, I enjoyed myself, so what's the problem? Because you didn't get laid tonight, but you still enjoyed yourself. Hallelujah. Mama, you may not have liked it when he called you a whore. Listen, you may not have liked it when I called you this. But first question, you need that, are you warm? And then outside of that, what about everything else I said? You mean one thing is going to keep you? Come on, come on, come on. It's one thing. Did one thing keep you from drinking? Went back to that Crown Royal. Expensive that that stuff was. It didn't stop me from drinking it. Since I loved it so much, I took a second job to buy it. What are you saying? My members, the members in my body, my arm, my eyes, my ears, my heart, convinced me, listen, we going to love this stuff. When y'all going to let your members, oh, hallelujah, say, we going to love praising God. We going to love lifting up Jesus. We going to love telling folks how good Jesus. We going to love this. And so flesh, you might as well get ready for it. Listen, the flesh, I don't want to fast, but that's for that. You fast in 2 days now. Hallelujah. You going to learn to like this stuff. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, I want y'all to think. I love it when y'all get excited and clap your hands, but I want you to think. Think about how you convinced folk to sing. Think about what you did to convince folk to sing. Women and men, children, boys and girls. Y'all got folks out there doing stuff. Listen, y'all convincing folk to do stuff that's wrong. When you going to convince them to do something right? When you going to convince them? Talking about instrument. Listen, this key. That's the only sound that key's supposed to make. When it make another one, it's what? No, broke. No, off key. You broke. When you can't get folks into the kingdom of God like he designed you to be, you're broke. You're broke. You ain't no good. And he said, when it ain't no good, gather them and throw them where? Hell. He said, the furnace of fire. That's hell. Y'all want God to gather some of y'all up? Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Come on, did we read anything yet? Chapter 10, verse 3. He said what? For though we walk in the flesh, You ain't warring against the flesh. You warring against your mind. I preached to y'all a few weeks ago about your mind, your disposition, the way you thought, the way you grew up had brought you to be where you are. Listen, I can't imagine what it's like. And listen, I don't sit around thinking that it's fun being a homosexual. I never was one. So I can't sit around and say that was fun, can I? That's your disposition. But guess what? As much as I hate drinking, I had some fun days drunk. I ain't going to tell that lie. I say, oh, no, all of them wasn't bad. So all of them wasn't bad. I'm being honest with you, especially in the early stage, because I wasn't an alcoholic. I wasn't dependent, because when I got dependent on the alcohol, sex wasn't good to me. All I wanted to do was get drunk. Listen, hallelujah. I got to the point, all I wanted was to get high. If a woman came along, hallelujah. And if she let me get too high, she can go home. I don't need you. Because I got my addiction. I'm fulfilled right now. I'm high as a kite. My mind is right. And I don't need nobody else. What are you saying? I got Jesus. I'm high as a kite. My mind is right. I don't need nobody but Jesus. Listen, I'm satisfied with who I got. Lisa is good to be there, but listen, I don't need you, baby. Not that I don't need sex. I just need Jesus, because Jesus can do this, and I don't want no sex. Oh, hallelujah. Went almost 7 years with no woman before I got saved. I got to the point, don't need that. Then Jesus said, oh, now I'm going to give you a woman and let you make a couple of babies. But I got to the point, Brother Raymond, I didn't need no woman. I was just happy going to church. I was happy praising God. What are you talking about? Instruments of righteousness, the instrument of God. But listen, y'all won't yield to nothing. Come on. So I ain't walking against the flesh, and I'm not warring in the flesh. Listen, I'm walking in the name of Jesus. It's time for us to get to the point. Jesus owned me. Jesus owned me, nobody else. My flesh don't own me no more. When it did, it dogged me out. When Satan owned me, he dogged me out. Jesus owned me, he taking good care. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Verse 4, he says what? For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through the pulling down. See, y'all got strongholds. Y'all got strongholds. Your biggest stronghold is your past memories. That's your biggest stronghold. That's your biggest stronghold. Because you don't want nobody to do nothing to you that you ain't used to having done to you. So every time somebody violates one of your rules, you got an attitude. Every time I preach something you don't like, you get an attitude. Well, let me ask you this. Do I ever preach something to you that I don't show you in the scripture? So don't blame the ministry. Blame your own stronghold. Listen, when you read something that you don't like, listen, don't blame the ministry. Blame your stronghold. Because you the one fell in love with that. And it was wrong back then. It is wrong yesterday. And it's wrong today. And it's gonna be wrong tomorrow. So you blaming the ministry ain't gonna change the word of God. You don't like the way I say something ain't gonna change what's written. Just because I don't say it to suit your vernacular. Oh, hallelujah. Just because I don't say it to suit your intellect, that don't make it wrong. I like preaching where it hits you in the chest. I don't want to hit your intellect. I want to hit your pride. Hitting your intellect make you not hear what I say. Tell my wife, okay, baby, that's enough. That's her intellect. When I say that's enough, she keep talking. I said, baby, okay, could you please be quiet? Now I'm appealing to her emotions. She still keep talking. Shut up, honey. Why you tell me to shut up? And she gone in the other room. She shut up, didn't she? So when I hit that pride, can't nobody tell me to shut up. That's rude. Find in the book where it says it's rude to tell a person to shut up. Find in the Bible where it's rude to tell a person to shut up. Jesus said it nice. He said, be slow to speak. And then at one point he said, study to be quiet. What does study to be quiet mean? Practice closing your mouth. Oh, hallelujah. What am I trying to say? Listen, let become instruments of righteousness. Let become instruments of God. Listen, I can say it nice, but is it going to make you remember what I said? But when I said the way I said, and all you old hard knock brothers, y'all know good and well, if I come in here and say, you know, why don't you please? Y'all ain't going to do nothing I say. Hallelujah. You hard knock women too. We all come off the streets. Y'all like we come out of Rose Garden houses. We come off the street where we were none but hustlers. Now y'all want to get over here. The devil talk to you mean. The devil talked to you mean and you took it. And then you want to come over here now and you want God to talk nice to you. You ain't going to pay him no attention. Oh, he preached too hard. Well, all I got is one question. You remember, I'm going to talk to these two brothers. Remember we used to go to the club? We go to the club and we get in and the whiskey a little more expensive because we went to a certain area. Like, hey, man, you know, I bought this at what you call club and it wasn't but... It was $2 cheaper. I said, well, taste it, brother. Oh, man, this is good. Because now you got real alcohol down there. It was watered down. You understand what I'm saying? You was getting watered down on that neighborhood corner bar. I done brought you up here where folks come in here to spend some money. They getting real whiskey. It ain't watered down. It's straight out the bottle. Hallelujah. And then on top of that, you down there with them women that kind of scandalous looking, right? Look at them women. Look at them women. I'm telling you like it is. Listen, you deal with, you got a whole different clientele. Let me tell you something. When you come to Jesus Christ the right way, it's a different clientele. Listen, when you want to be a saint, it's a whole different way of thinking. Now, if you want to be a Christian, I'm going to talk to you tonight. But if you want to be a saint, I'm going to hit you smack dab in your mouth and let you know you got a problem and you need to change it. Listen, I want to be an instrument of righteousness. I want to be an instrument of God. Listen, you want some good word or you want some watered down word? Well, God loves you. You're going to be all right. God loves you, but except you repent, you're going to hell. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Verse 5, he said what? We're talking about instruments of God. Casting down imagination and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge. Anything that tells you the word ain't right. Anything that tells you to do something that the word does not tell you. Listen, cast down that imagination. Listen, hallelujah. If God tell you to do it, you got to do it. I'm talking about instruments. I don't play the piano, but if I come over here to hit this note and I get that note, something wrong. God called you to win folks to heaven, to Christ, and you doing what? You ain't winning nobody? Are you an instrument of God or are you an instrument of somebody else? If God told you to go out and win soul and you doing something totally different, so who do you belong to? Who are you yielding to? Amen. Cast down every mind, imagination, and high thing that exalted itself against the God. And bring it into what? Bring it into what? Captivity. Every thought. I like that. I'm gonna preach that whole verse one day. I have to cut it up because that ain't the total message. It's part of it. Excuse me. Bring every thought into the obedience of Christ. That means everything I think about, if it's not conforming to God, I give you a good one. Friday, I think it was. I was a good dice shooter. I cheated a lot, but I was a good dice shooter. Whether I did it right or whether I cheated, you know. I almost got killed a couple of times. But I was a good dice cheater. A shooter. I was a good dice cheater too. Amen. I was driving the other day, and I saw these Hispanics. They was under a tree, shooting dice on the sidewalk. Let me tell you what the flesh said to me. Man, you remember how good it used to be to shoot the dice? Now I ain't shot dice. What I got I got baptized in 1988. I don't think I shot dice since 1987. Cause when I came out here, I didn't know nobody. So you know, you wait till you get to know people before you go to shooting dice. Cause shooting dice is a dangerous game. You can get killed quick. Anybody know about shooting dice? We call them bones. But anyway, I saw him shooting dice. Now, 1987. It's 2017. The devil, the flesh, the devil, my thought, I put it on me. My thought said, man,
remember how it used to be where you would walk up to a game like that? He said, that used to be fun. I said, you know, you're right, but I don't do that no more. Casting it down. See, God said the thoughts are going to come, y'all. But when they come, you cast them down. Don't walk around saying, well, the devil getting the best of me and the devil getting the best of you because you want to go back and do it. Listen, Crown Royal, listen, they got a Crown Royal now called black. They didn't have black when I was drinking it. I told y'all my story about Crown Royal. Listen, they got it black. Listen, I seen another flavor the other day on a billboard. Listen, what am I saying? Listen, the flesh always say, remember, yes, I ain't forgot that. But here's the problem. I don't do that no more. I got you in captivity. You captured. You ain't listening. And I'm not opening up the jail cell. You ain't coming out. Y'all know when you open up the jail cell? When you go try it again. When you go dabbing back in it. When you go looking at it. Y'all get married. Then you go to looking at another woman or another man because you just opened it. You took the key, unlocked it, and let that demon back out. You think that demon going back in that cave easy? That's why when you backslide, it's hard to come back because you let them demons. And the Bible says something about when he go out and find his nowhere to go and he come back, he bringing seven with him. Because when he come back to get into jail, he ain't coming back. He bringing some help. In other words, you ain't going to just go back to smoking. You're going to smoke crack. You're going to smoke cigarette. You're going to smoke dope. You're going to look at women or men. Listen, you're going all the way back. Ain't no such thing as a little way back. Listen, cast down that imagination and bring it to the obedience. Meaning make yourself do what is right by the word of God. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. What verse was that? That was 5. 6 says what? And having in a readiness. Are y'all ready to do right? I mean, no. Don't answer so fast. Because that might be your emotions overriding your intellect. In other words, your intellect overriding your Holy Ghost. Are y'all ready to do right? I mean, are you really ready to do right? Are you really to work and bring folks to Christ? That means put your life on the shelf this day. Amen. All of y'all that ain't saved, you saying you want to do right? It's time for you to deny the flesh right now, today. He said, I'm the one support you. I'm the one that drew you here. You didn't come here because somebody invited you. I used that person to invite you because that's their job, is to do what I tell them to do. Now let's go to Matthew chapter 28. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. What are you talking about? The instruments of God. Listen, it's time for us to become instruments of God. We've been the instrument of the devil long enough. Long enough. Long enough. Long enough. Y'all hear what I'm saying? You've been the instrument of Satan long enough. Ain't you tired of it? Ain't you tired of waking up worried? Ain't you tired of waking up hungover? Ain't you tired of waking up not knowing what's going to happen to you today? Listen, ain't nothing like waking up and don't care what happened to you today. I don't care what happened to me today. I'm an instrument of God. And you can't do nothing to me if God don't let you. So whatever happened to me, it was supposed to happen to me. So I couldn't have defeated it no way. But y'all wake up and don't know what's going to happen. And y'all worried about what's going to happen. I ain't worried. I ain't never worried about what I'm going to wake up. I won't say ever, but it's been so long now worrying that what I don't know what's going to happen. I don't care. Guess what? Because God got me. I'm an instrument of God. I'm an instrument of Jesus Christ. So whatever come my way, listen, I got a scripture to bag me up. All things work together for the good, for those who love God, and those are called according to his purpose. Now, let's listen. Let's dissect that verse for a minute before we go over here. And love God. Now, are called according to his purpose. He called me before I loved him. He called me before I loved him. He put it in the reverse order. Because he's saying now, John, I called you to be a pastor before you even loved me. Now you've learned to love me. Now I'm going to ask you a question. Do you love me? What did he tell Peter? Peter, do you love me? Peter said, yeah, Lord, you know I feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. Because you've been with me 3.5 years. Later on, he said, Peter, let me ask you a question. Do you love me? He said, yeah, Lord, thou knowest I love thee. He said, well, feed my sheep. Amen. Later on, he said, Peter,
Do you love me? Peter said, Lord, you know, wait a minute. He said, well, there's going to come a day, Peter, when somebody going to have to guide you because you're going to be half blind and you're going to be crippled. Now, and you better feed my lamb. Now, before he said lamb, then he said, you better feed my sheep. What is he saying? Lamb are newborn. Sheep are full-grown knucklehead folk that don't want to listen. He said, you still got to feed them. But do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? All things work together for those that love the Lord. Do you love him? If you love him, he called you to do something. What did he call you to do? He called me to be a pastor. He called y'all to do whatever that gift survey told y'all. He said, now do you love me? Because you know what I've called you to do. There's no more confusion there. Right? Everybody got that? That's why he had you to do the survey. So you know that. But see, now here come the million-dollar question. Since you know what he called you to do, the only way you're going to do what he called you to do, you got to love him. Do you love him? Are you willing to be his instrument? Are you ready for him to just use you, whatever he wants you to do? Are you ready for that? Or you still got reservation and you still questioning? Then you might want to ask yourself. That's why I can wake up every day. I ain't worried about what's going to happen to me. For a long time, I was a dope head. I was all them things. But at 28, he secured me. He drew me. Listen, you think he drew me to use me to send me back out to the devil? He didn't do it to y'all either. He didn't do it to y'all either. So when are you going to become an instrument of God and not an instrument of the devil? Come on. Matthew 28, 18. We got it? What does he say? And Jesus, all power. All power. All power. All power is given unto him. Well, all power. Jesus got all power, right? All power. What y'all worried about then? Tell me he got all power. What you worried about? You think his power is limited or restricted? Why are you worrying? What you worrying for then? All power. I run the devil and I run heaven. I thought God run heaven because I'm God. Y'all don't get it. That's what Jesus would tell them. I'm God. You don't get it. When did God give anybody a power in heaven? Somebody wanted it, and what did he do with them? Kicked them out. Jesus, all power. I control every devil and demon, and I control every angel. So why are you worried, John? What do you have to fear? Everybody is in my control, John. And you worried? Why can't you do what I tell you to do? Why can't you become an instrument for me? Ooh, hallelujah. Think about this now. If he got all power, all power, why don't you let him control you since he got all power? All power. In heaven and earth. So nobody can do nothing to me without Jesus' approval. Nobody. So why do I wake up worried? Now if I love him, why don't I just go and bow and let him do what he want to do? Guess what? He got all power. I might as well bow, huh? Don't that make sense? Since he got all power, I might as well bow. Come on. And then he said, now go. This is what I want y'all to do. I got all power, but this is what I want y'all to do. Read. He said what? Wait a minute. Go ye therefore and teach all. All nation, everybody. That's why I'm on the internet and sci-fi and all these things. I'm going to teach all nation. I want everybody. Yet, nobody, folks act like they don't know me, but I'm well known. I know that already. Folks see me, and then they say, I recognize you. I don't know where I'm from, even though I know. If you can't remember, I ain't going to help you remember. Come on, read. He said, go ye therefore and teach all nation, baptizing them in the name. What's the name of the Father? Jesus. But some folk don't believe it. Who got all power in heaven? Jesus. But I thought God had all power. I thought he was the Father of creation. So how did Jesus go up there and kick the daddy to the curb? Because I am the daddy. I ain't kicked myself to the curb. I got some titles that y'all didn't know about. And one of them is Father. What else he said? He said, what up? And I thought the son was an offspring of somebody else. Oh, hallelujah. How can the son be the offspring of somebody else if the somebody else is him? Oh, hallelujah. What am I saying? Listen, I need y'all to go out and identify. Let folks know who I am. Come on. Next one. He said what? And the Holy Ghost can't come unless I go away. And when I send him back, he going to teach and guide you. So I need y'all. Listen, Church of Apostolicity, I need y'all talking in the mind of God. I need y'all to go out and explain to folks that Jesus is the Father. Jesus is the Son. Jesus is the Holy Ghost. Listen, but y'all running around confused because y'all don't believe it yourself. Because you won't be an instrument. Listen, you better make the right sound. You better make the right sound. He said, I'm the Father, I'm the Son. Now go out and tell them what my name is. Go out and tell them. He said, I'm commissioning y'all to go out and tell folks who I am. He said, because I got all power. All power. I mean, I run heaven. Come on. I got to go. I didn't read this verse. Go back to, what was it, Lord? Oh, I didn't read it at all. Matthew chapter 18. Thank you, Lord. I love this. Are y'all with me? I hope I ain't boring you. Hope y'all getting this. It's time for us to do our job. It's time for us to do our job. Come on. Come on. Where we at? Verse 8, chapter 18 of the book of Matthew. Come on. Just a few verses over here. Then I'm going to let you go. I'm going to let you come up and get prayer. I hope somebody wants the Holy Ghost today. Today a good day to speak in tongues. Come on, verse 18 said what? Verily, I want water, honey. Verily, I say unto you, whatsoever you shall, and whatsoever, look at the power. Look at the power that God gave saints. We can make some laws in heaven. Can I explain that for a minute? He said, whatever you loose on earth shall be loose. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound. Whatever you loose in heaven shall be loose. Whatever you bind in heaven shall be bound. Now watch this. Because Jesus has got all power, he knows what he going to let your mind think and say. So he know you ain't going to say nothing stupid and cause confusion up there because he ain't going to let you do it. Because he the one gives you your thoughts. So he didn't have a problem saying what he said. Because he know, I got control. I got all power in heaven and earth. So, Tony, you can't think nothing bad because I ain't going to give it to you. I ain't going to let you think it. Amen. He said, but I'm going to make you think good. Whatever rule you set up, I'm gonna tell the folks in heaven. We got to obey that. But guess what? He said, John, I'm only going to give you rule that in the Bible so you ain't going to never say nothing crazy because everything you say going to come out the scripture. Amen. Hallelujah. So he said, when I give you power in heaven and earth, you ain't going to say nothing. That's why a person with the Holy Ghost can't preach. Because they don't have no power. You only get power when you get the Holy Ghost. He said, after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, you shall receive power. Because the first one holler, that ain't no power. That's just you running your mouth. Amen. He said, the power is you're going to speak in an unknown tongue. You're going to say something that you don't know what you're saying, but yet you feel good on the inside. Hallelujah. You ain't going to be running into no wall. Hallelujah. So what are you saying? God said, you can't talk my word until you get me on the inside. And when you get me on the inside, I'm running things. And if I'm running things, you can bind because I'm doing the binding. You can loose because I'm doing the loosing. You are just you are just an instrument. Y'all didn't get that. John, you just the instrument. So why don't you let me bind stuff, loose stuff? Why don't you let me control you and watch? Oh, hallelujah. Watch what you can do. But you got to let me control you. When you control yourself, you're going to say things you ain't got no business saying. But when you let me control you, you ain't going to say nothing crazy. Come on, a couple more verses. What else he saying? 19, I say unto you. Now let's go back to 28. Listen, let me tell you this. Let me share this with you. The reason I can put you all over different auxiliaries, because I trust you. Because I know you ain't going to say nothing crazy. Amen. Some of y'all ain't putting you over no auxiliary, because you don't let me control you yet. Amen. When I know I got control over a person, they know how I think. I know they ain't going to do nothing crazy in that auxiliary. See, some of y'all want to be over some, but I can't trust you. Amen. You ain't there yet. Listen, I'm only going to put people. Listen, I'm putting Aaron over the young people. I'm crazy about these young people, because I know if we can get them right now, they'll never go astray. Do you think I'll put somebody over my young people that's going to distort them, that's going to put stuff in their head? Do you think I'll put somebody in there that's going to tell the young people, well, pastor don't understand, so we're going to do it this way? No. I ain't put nobody in there making no comment like that. Amen. Pastor don't have to understand. Just do what pastor said. Whether he tell you he understand or not is irrelevant. Just do what he said. Amen. I don't need nobody in there second guessing me. I don't need nobody on no auxiliary second guessing me. Hallelujah. I don't allow my wife to second guess me when it comes to my boy. If I tell them boys to do something, they know. They say, but mama say, I said, well, you tell me who's in charge. Who getting ready to hit you in your mouth? Your mama or me? Make a decision. Your mama don't run this house. I do. Amen. I understand she told you your way out is to say, daddy said, now mama ain't going to mess with you. But you're going to stand there and ignore daddy and obey mama and knowing daddy going to punish you. Y'all want to listen to your spouses and your kids and your mamas and your daddy and ignore God. Who going to punish you? Who's going to punish you? What can your wife do to you other than get mad? What can your husband do other than get mad? But what can God do? God said, don't fear man. Fear him that can destroy the body and the soul. Y'all, because you ain't allowing yourself to be no instrument. He said, go ye, teaching them to observe all things. I'm back in chapter 28, verse 20. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I and lo. Come on, get on your feet. Get on your feet. Get on your feet. Come on, minister. Somebody want the Holy Ghost today. Somebody want to get baptized. It's a good day to get the Holy Ghost. It's a good day to get baptized. God drew you here today. Don't waste it. Don't waste this opportunity. Amen. Listen, you may say you've been baptized. Do you know if it was in Jesus' name or not? If you don't know, fix it. It ain't going to hurt you. We got everything you need. We got all the clothes you need, everything. It's all white and fresh. Smell like bleach, ladies. Y'all like that bleach smell. Amen. It's clean. What am I saying? It's a good day. This is a good day, y'all. It's a good day to get baptized. It's a good day to get the Holy Ghost. It's a good day to say, I'm committed. It's a good day to say, I'm yielding my instruments now. It's time for us to change. Come on, you ready to yield your instrument. Come on, get prayer. Amen. If you know that. Now, don't just do it just to be running up here. You got to say, I'm ready and willing to yield my instruments to righteousness. Amen. Because you got to become an instrument of God. As long as you're an instrument of the devil, you ain't going to survive. Not over here, not in this kingdom. Listen, not in the presence of God. Amen. This is an opportunity. This is an opportunity. Amen. Hallelujah. To yield yourself to righteousness.
Hallelujah.
I like to see the young people come. Listen, young people say they want to do right. Listen, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Young folks want to do right. Us old folks, sometimes we slow. We got to evaluate everything and figure stuff out. That's the problem. You're too busy figuring stuff out. You're coming up with the same stuff. Just believe the word. Just believe the word. Just believe the word. Just believe the word. Just believe it. Believe it. Believe it. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
talk to the Lord where you're standing. You don't want to come up for prayer, at least talk to him where you're standing. So I want to be an instrument of God, not for God. Don't confuse it. Don't walk out changing it. Not for God, of God. For meaning I'm going to do what I want to do when I want to do it. Of God meaning he got full control over me. I want to be an instrument of God. I want God to have full control over me. Full control. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Full control. I want God to have full control. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I know somebody want to be baptized today. Somebody want the Holy Ghost. Whenever God had me preach about it, that means somebody is in their mind. Come on, come on. Don't stop. It's in your mind. You might as well do it. Somebody want the Holy Ghost. Because I don't preach about Holy Ghost, getting the Holy Ghost and baptism on every Sunday. Somebody want it. You might as well come on, get it, man, and get it out the way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You might as well come on. You know you want it. Listen, look at me. I got the Holy Ghost. Do I look like I'm sad? Do I look like I'm worried? I'm not worried about nothing. Hallelujah. Sufficient today is the evil thereof. I'm not taking thought of tomorrow. Tomorrow sufficient. Listen, the evil going to take care of itself tomorrow. And righteousness going to take care of itself. But today, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He is coming.
He's coming. He's coming. He's coming.
He is coming.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
He is
hallelujah.
Coming.
He's coming.
He is coming.
He's coming. He's coming.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's sing that song with Sister Nina.
Hallelujah.
Come on, sing it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Y'all, I tell y'all, that word hallelujah means this is it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah means this is it. That's the biggest praise when you can give God. Like, this is it, Lord. I ain't looking for nothing else. I ain't searching for nothing else. I'm sold out. I'm sold out on you, Lord. Hallelujah. This is it. That's becoming an instrument of God. When you're saying, this is it. It's, I don't want nothing else. I don't want nothing else. He want to be baptized? That's what I'm talking about. All right. Go on in there. Go on in there. That's right. Now see, what's about to happen to him, every sin he committed, God is getting ready to say he don't remember it no more. Lord, I don't care what he's done. Y'all may remember it, but God is saying, I don't remember it. Once he come up out that water, he's clean. Clean as a whistle.
Lord,
hallelujah. Why would a person pass up being clean like that? All of your sins removed, not
Lord,
forgiven, removed. There's a difference between forgiven and remove. Remove meaning it's like they never were there.
Lord, I love
oh, hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord,
this is
I
it.
Love
this is it. I don't want nothing else but Jesus.
Lord,
this is
I
it.
Love
this
you.
Is it. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love
Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I
Lord, I love you.
You.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Come on, nobody else. Nobody wants prayer. Nobody wants the Holy Ghost. Nobody wants to be baptized. Everybody good.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let us stand on our feet. I want to see the brother get baptized. The last time I missed the other one. I ain't missing this one. I want to see him go down. Amen. I want to see him go down. I want to see him come up with no sins on him. Bring back when I got baptized. God saw a no good fellow and cleaned him up. And here I stand before you today, some 29 years later, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Declaring what I learned. Like Paul said, I was a persecutor, but now here I am declaring the faith I once persecuted. Listen, isn't that something? Listen, God is good, man. God, oh, hallelujah. God is good. With upraised hands, Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, we say thank you because you're good and your mercy endures forever. We thank you, Lord. We want to be your instruments. Father, help us to walk out of here being an instrument of you, not for you, of you, not an instrument for you, of you. That means you got 100% control. Hallelujah. We don't want to be used sometime. We want the Holy Ghost to generate everything that come through our mind, that come to our thought, that generates in our heart. We want the Holy Ghost to change the way we think, change the way we act, change the way we talk, change where we go, change how we live, change how we dress, change. We want to become the instrument that don't make a certain sound, but make a righteous sound, that don't sound like a tinkling brass, hallelujah, but we want to make the right sound. We don't want to be a sound that just make a noise. We want to make the right sound. We don't want to do things halfway. We want to do things all the way. We don't want to be partially in your kingdom. We want to be controlled by your kingdom. Father, we thank you right now for touching our heart and touching our mind, touching the very thought, hallelujah, that goes through our thought pattern, Lord Jesus. We want you to fix everything about us, fix everything in us, fix everything around us, hallelujah, that we can be instruments, hallelujah, that make the right sound every time we wake up, every time we open our mouth, of every time we do what you tell us to do. We want to be right. We want to be holy. We want to be, Lord God, the way you called us to be. We thank you for it right now, because you say where two or three are gathered together asking anything in your name, you are in the midst. Hallelujah. Lord, you got more than two or three here this morning. You got more than five or six. You got more than 10 or 15. You got more than 20 or 25. Lord, we are here because we want to serve you. We're here because we love you. We're here because we want to obey you. Hallelujah. So we thank you. We thank you. We thank you for calling us here. We thank you for securing us here this day, that we can learn more about you, Father. Bless the brother that's going down in your name. Father, right now, give him a new thought pattern. Hallelujah. As he begins to change his clothes, Father, help him to see things differently right now. Oh, Lord Jesus, let him come up out of the water speaking in an unknown tongue that only your spirit can give, Father. Let him see what the Holy Ghost is like. Let him see what it means to be saved. Hallelujah. Let him experience the life of a saint. Oh, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father. And Lord, we thank you for bringing us back here at 6 o'clock, where we can praise you some more on this evening. We love you, Lord. Bless our visitors, Lord God. Let them take the word and hide it in their heart like never before. Let them begin to see a new side of Jesus Christ that they, oh, hallelujah, that they never seen before. Father, we thank you. We thank you for every good work that you've done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Remember to keep the sanctuary quiet. Also remember the young people, officers, I need to see you at 4 o'clock. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let's watch the brother get baptized.